Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 8 of Java and Web, Modular Programming in Java. In this video, we will learn about optional dependency in modular programming. One of the properties of the modular programming is, if a module is absent from the module path, then you cannot run the rest of the compiled modules, even if at the time of execution, the absent module is not required. We already have seen in the previous videos that if the module is not present in the module path, then we cannot start the execution, even if the absent module is not required. If a module in the module path is not present, the execution cannot even start. But sometimes you need to execute a code even if few modules are not present at the time of execution. And this situation can be dealt with a concept called optional dependency. In the directory other module, we have a compiled code of the module named myModuleB. This is the compiled code of the module myModuleB. In the directory src, we have the source code of the module myModuleA. Let's go and see the source code of the module myModuleA. Go inside the directory myModuleA, open moduleinfo.java. Moduleinfo.java requires the module myModuleB. Let's go in the package directory mypack1 and open m1.java. The package statement of m1.java is package mypack1, which is importing a class m2 from the package mypack2. The package mypack2 is present in the module myModuleB. Then after in the method main of the class m1, we are printing a string imm1. In the method main of the class m1, we are calling a static method print of the class m2. And finally, we are again printing the string imm1 again. Let's execute this code. First, we need to compile this code. We are using the Java C compiler. Our module source path is present in the src directory and a compiled module is present in the directory other module. And we want to store the compiled code of the module myModuleA in the directory out. Press enter. It compiled fine and the directory out has been created on the desktop. And the directory out contains the compiled code of the module myModuleA. Now let's run this code. Followed by Java command, we need to provide the module path. Since our compiled modules are present in two directories, one is the directory out and other one is the directory other module. That's how we have provided the names of two directories separated by a colon. If you are using Linux, then you need to write here colon. And if you are using Windows, then you need to write here a semicolon. Followed by the option M, we need to pass the name of the class present in the package mypack1. And the package mypack1 is in the module myModuleA. The class M1 contains the method main. Press enter. It executes fine printing imm1, imm2, and then imm1 again. The string imm2 is printed by the static method print of the class m2. If we do not provide the module path to the module myModuleB, that is the directory other module, then our code will not run fine. Let's erase the directory name other module. Press enter. At this time, the code has not started the execution. It is saying that error occurred during initialization of boot layer. java.lang.module.findException. Module myModuleB not found, required by the module myModuleA. What I want is, my code should start execution even if the module myModuleB is not present. And if the module myModuleB is not present, then I want to handle this exception by myself. To achieve this requirement, I need to make the module myModuleA optionally dependent on the module myModuleB. To make the module myModuleA optionally dependent on the module myModuleB, we need to change the code of the module myModuleA. We need to make a change in the moduleinfo.java of the module myModuleA. Right here requires static myModuleB. By writing here static, we are assuring that the module myModuleA is optionally dependent on the module myModuleB. That means the code will start execution even if the module myModuleB is not present in the module path. Let's delete the directory out from the desktop. Delete it. Now compile this code once again. Using Java C compiler, same as we did before. Compiles fine and the directory out has been again created on the desktop. Now let's try to run this code. Clear the screen. Try to run it. Press enter. It's printing imm1, but then after it cannot find the module myModuleB. And it's throwing an error, the java.lang.noClassDefFoundError, mypack2m2. Since the module myModuleA is optionally dependent on the module myModuleB, So the module my module B is not resolved by the module resolution process. And the module my module A see the package my pack2 as if it does not belong to any other module. It's a normal package. That's how it is throwing java.lang.noClassDefFoundError exception instead of java.lang.module.findException. After compiling the module my module A, which optionally requires the module my module B, if somehow we can get the compiled code of the module my module B, then we can run it. Let's try to run this code because we know that the compiled code of the module my module B is present in the directory other module. I am going to execute the Java command with the module path option followed by the directory names out colon other module. But do you know, this command will also not execute fine. Press enter. It is showing same error as we have not provided the path to the module my module B. But here we are providing the module path to the module my module B. Then why this error occurs? Actually, the JVM not included the module my module B in its module resolution process. So the module my module B is not in the list of the observable modules of the JVM because it requires static. That's how if the module my module A optionally dependent on the module my module B, we need to provide another option to the Java command. Clear the screen. We need to provide another option, that is add modules option. Followed by the option add modules, we need to write the name of the module on which our current module in execution is optionally dependent. We need to provide it followed by add modules because the JVM will not include the module my module B in the module resolution process. And the module my module B is not the part of the observable module, even if you are providing the path to the module my module B. Press enter. At this time it runs fine, printing IMM1, IMM2 and IMM1 again. That's all for this video guys. Don't forget to like and share this video, subscribe my channel on YouTube, like my page on Facebook and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.